As our next distinguished speaker, I would like to welcome His Excellency Mr. Rudiantara, the Minister of Communication and IT from the Republic of Indonesia, one of the co-chairs of the Group of Friends. Minister.
Her Majesty Queen Maxima of the Netherlands, distinguished speakers, my friends here, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. Digital economy is something foreseeable in Indonesia. Our country, with 260 million people, is a firm believer on the digital economy. Next year, our digital economy will reach $130 billion, or represents slightly over 11% of our real GDP. Why we believe on the digital economy? Number one, reason number one, this digital economy create workforce digitizations. As we see here, this standing banner, Gojek, on the movie Gojek, they create a new worker, which is digital workforce. Gojek type of application is no longer the ride hailing in the country. They are now is becoming the super apps. It's a lifestyle. It's not only ride hailing. We can order the food from Gojek, which is what we call food. And this create the new micro, small, medium enterprises. For the one who would like to have a restaurant, they are good in cooking something, they have to lease the space. But with these applications, so for the one who are good in cooking something, as long as they have a good brand, they can deliver it directly to their kitchens, delivered by Gojek. The e-commerce platform in Indonesia, one of them, they have 7 million merchants. And out 7 million merchants, 70% are the one who never been in the business before. So this is really create the micro, small, medium enterprises with this digitization. Reason number two, shared economy. Always shared economy, shared economy, shared economy. In this Gojek business model, who own the asset, who own the motorcycle, who own the bicycle, it's not the company, it's not the Gojek, it's not the apps, but the people on the bike, motorbike. Who on the kitchen? It's not Gojek, it's not in their balance sheet, but people. This is what we call a shared economy. And more important things is number three, which is financial inclusions. Gojek, they have GoPay. Only within the years, they have processed $6 billion transaction. So that's why we are a firm believer on digital economy. In particular, on the financial inclusions. Thank you, Excellency Queen Maxima. Indonesia has also developed the national strategy for financial inclusion to boost economic growth through equal income distribution, poverty reduction, and financial stability, which is consists of five pillars. Number one, financial education. Number two, property right. The government has issued more than 20 million certificates of the land. So the landowner, they can use the certificate for the guarantee to get the loan from the banks right now. This is only for the last 3 years. Third, intermediation and financial distributions. We promote more branchless banks in the country, use the technology, find the new ways, find the new business process, maximizing the use of technology. Third, government financial services. Fifth, consumer protections. And those five pillars supported by three fundamental strategies. Number one is policy and regulations. Second, effective organizations and mechanism. And last but not least, is the ICT infrastructures. Indonesia consists of 17,000 islands, some ask me, Rudy, are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. Weather depends on the whether it's high tide or low tide. But anyway, this is how to share with you how big is our country. It's not land, it's not pretty much land countries, which is easier to build the ICT infrastructure. Thanks, we have completed with the project, we call it Palaparing, that we built the backbone for broadband that connect the whole region throughout the country, which is 540 countries. So there is no reasons that we are not be able to speed up, to boost the financial inclusion in the country. I would like also to extend my sincere thank you to Excellency Queen Maxima that always keep her eye to Indonesia. By this, I would like to conclude my remarks, my statements, and thank you very much to all of you.
Thank you, Minister, for bringing to life what financial inclusion means on the ground and explain your government's plans.